गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस क्लास इज़ फॉर क्लास फोर सोशल स्टडीज़ क्लास एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट चैप्टर फाइव और न्यू चैप्टर दैट इज़ द कोस्टल प्लेन्स एंड द आइलैंड्स. सो यू ऑल विल ओपन योर बुक एंड फॉलो. द कोस्टल प्लेन्स, अ कोस्ट इज़ द लैंड विच इज़ नियर टू द सी. सो यू अंडरस्टैंड द मीनिंग ऑफ कोस्ट. कोस्ट इज़ द लैंड विच इज़ नियर टू अ सी. India has a fairly long coastline along the peninsula bordering the Arabian Sea on the west and the Bay of Bengal on the east. The length of the coastal plain is about 6,000 km and width varies from 50 km in the south to 250 km in the west. Okay, now students, we will know about the western coastal plain. The western coastal plains begins from the run of Kutch in the Gujarat and moves southwards along the western borders of Maharashtra, Goa, Karnataka and Kerala to Kanyakumari to the southmost tip of Indian mainland. The western coastal plain is bound by the Arabian Sea on the west and the Western Ghat on the east, is bordered between the Gulf of Kutch and Gulf of Khambhat. From the Gulf of Khambhat, it narrows down sharply to the south of India. It ends in Kanyakumari in the south. A gulf is a narrow inlet. Okay, a gulf is a narrow inlet of sea surrounded by land on three sides. The western coastal plain is divided into three parts: the Gujarat coast, the Konkan coast, and the Malabar coast. The Gujarat coast lies between the Gulf of Kutch and the Gulf of Khambhat. The Konkan coast extends from the Gulf of Khambhat up to Goa. It is rocky and narrow and hilly. Go up to the seashore in many places. Lighthouses have been built along the coast to warn ships against the rocks. Many harbors are found there. Mumbai is the biggest commercial port on the Konkan coast. This coast is rich in oil deposits and many oil wells are found here. The Malabar coast lies to the south of the Konkan coast and extends from Goa to Kanyakumari. A large number of lagoons are found here, especially in Kerala. So children, do you know what are lagoons? Yes, lagoons are small and shallow saltwater lakes or ponds that cut themselves off from the main sea by rock or sandbars. They are also known as backwaters and are connected with one another by canals. Now you turn the page. Traveling through the backwaters in boat and steamer is a major tourist attraction. The canals are also used for transporting goods. Kochi is the most important port on Malabar coast. The climate here is hot and humid throughout the year. It rains heavily during the monsoon. People here grow tobacco, banana, rice, sugarcane, clover, coffee, cashew nuts, and groundnuts. So many tasty things, isn't it? Okay. Coconut trees are found all along the Malabar coast. Fishing is an important occupation. So you can understand that a land which is surrounded by water, there people will do fishing. Fishing will be their important occupation. Now come to the eastern coastal plain. The eastern coastal plain lies between the Bay of Bengal and the Eastern Ghats. It begins from West Bengal in the north and ends at Kanyakumari in the south. As we travel northwards along the Bay of Bengal from Kanyakumari to West Bengal, we noticed that the eastern coastline is wider than the western coastline. The northern part of the plains are known as northern sirkars, and the southern parts are called Coromandel Coast. The region is very fertile and rice and sugarcane are grown here. Coconut, cotton and jute are other crops cultivated here. Chennai and Visakhapatnam are the two large ports. So what are the two large ports? Chennai and Visakhapatnam, okay? There is a shipbuilding yard at Visakhapatnam. This region has only a few good harbors. Now you come to next page, page number 33, the importance of the coastal plain. Coastal area are the real asset of the country. Yes, it's a very important thing that coastal areas are the real asset of a country. Many ports are found along the coast which are important for inland and foreign trade. The seaside towns of Goa, Kochi, etc. are popular tourist destinations. Fishing is an important occupation and industry. A large variety of crops like rice, coconut, rubber, jute are grown here as the land is fertile. The islands. An island is a piece of land surrounded by water on all sides. There are two main groups of islands. The Andaman and Nicobar Island in the Bay of Bengal. The Lakshadweep Island in the Arabian Sea. The climate is pleasant, warm and tropical. It is pleasant due to cool sea breeze. Okay. The Andaman and Nicobar Islands. These islands are located in the Bay of Bengal. There are two groups of about 300 islands, with the Andaman group in the north and Nicobar Island in the southern group. The Andaman and Nicobar Islands are the union territories of India. The capital is Port Blair. So the capital of Andaman and Nicobar Island is Port Blair. These islands are covered with forest and very few people inhabit them. The tribal people here still live in their old traditional way. Barren Island, which has the only active volcano, is located here. Rice and coconut are the major crops. Fishing is an important occupation. Now we will know about Lakshadweep Island. Off the Malabar coast in the Arabian Sea lie the Lakshadweep Islands. It is the smallest union territory of India. Children, do remember this, that Lakshadweep Island is the smallest union territories of India. Territory of India. It consists of 36 islands, out of which only 11 are inhabited. So can you imagine, there are 36 islands, but in that 36 island only 11 are inhabited. That means people live in only 11 islands, remaining is empty. Fishing is the important occupation and coconut is the main crop. Kavaratti is the capital of Lakshadweep. So capital of Lakshadweep is Kavaratti. Most of these islands are ring-shaped coral islands as they are made of deposits of the hard body covering of sea animals called corals. The importance of the islands. These groups of islands are famous tourist attractions. The climate here, in spite of being warm and tropical, is very pleasant due to cool sea breeze. So this much you will read today again and again. And if you have any problem or doubt, you will ask me. This much for today's class. Have a good day. Bye-bye.